Now, to be fair, we don't know who tore them down.
Well, right? I'm sure it wasn't. Honestly, I doubt it was anybody that had anything to do with the Black Lives Matter movement, unless it was the Antifa that were like jumping in behind them.
I hate to say it, man.
Steering them.
Black Lives Matter has been totally hijacked.
I mean, we'll see. I don't know.
It has.
I see a lot of things coming out of who the leaders are, and it's not what I would have thought what Black Lives Matter means.
So we had, I think it was Minneapolis, and I can't remember the other place. I did a segment on this. And London, two high profile organizers quit, saying straight up, they've hijacked the movement. They're talking about abolishing capitalism. What is this?
Right.
It's not what Black Lives Matter was supposed to be. And honestly, like, if you look back, because I remember covering these protests, it was specifically about police brutality.
Right.
Now they're talking about weird abolishing the police. Yeah, that's just their in. They've taken the brand. You know, that there was a guy who started a foundation called Black Lives Matter in California. He's okay. Raised hundreds of thousands of dollars. He pays himself $24,000 a year. And he said his goal is to work with the police and do community building events where the people can go have a picnic with cops. So it brings people together.
That's awesome.
So BuzzFeed did an investigation, and now a bunch of his fundraising has been suspended so that the real organization.
Of course.
The Marxists.
Right.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. So I actually got into an argument with some people on Facebook. This happened all the time. I'm actually starting to enjoy it because no. I'll explain why. It's because I am furthering my own knowledge. Because they will come at me and I'm like, okay, I'm going to further myself. I'm going to read what you're giving to me. I'm going to look up my own side of things and see what the deal is. And then I continue the conversation, which is what I'm trying to have. They keep trying to have this argument with me. And they're talking about the bill that was trying to be passed.
Which one?
By the Republicans. The police reform bill.
Yeah, Tim Scott was leading that, wasn't he?
Yeah, and they were all saying it wasn't enough. We need more. And I'm like, you know what? Let me dig into this bill. What's in this bill that wasn't enough? What is it? You know? And I'm looking, and I actually have pretty much the list.
So let's quick context.
Go ahead.
The Black Lives Matter movement says we want to defund the police.
Right.
They then say no. We don't mean abolish outright, though some do. We're talking about just reform.
Right.
So the Republicans offered up a reform bill led by Senator Tim Scott. They rejected it and even dropped in a racial slur, a passive racial slur, which Tim Scott got really mad about that. But anyway, that's the context. So now Adam's arguing with people.
Well, so I read it and I'm like, you know what? What is it about that they don't think is enough? I'm just going to read. There's some bullet points basically listing some of the things this bill covers. You know, chokeholds are discouraged, disincentivized. Increased data collection on the use of force, increased records retention, no-knock warrant tracking, make lynching a federal crime, include increasing penalties for false police reports, enhance funding for body cams, study on social status of black men and boys, funding for training on alternate uses of force, de-escalation, and duty to intervene, banning sexual abuse by law enforcement, and African American History Museum to train law enforcement on the history of racism.
Wow.
I wasn't even expecting that last one.
That is a heavy cultural concession from Republicans.
But look at that list. Where do you let people start making a fix if you're not even going to say this wasn't enough?
Wait, hold on. The Republicans proposed
right.
a museum?
That's correct.
A Black History Museum for cultural training?
That is correct. For police officers.
Wow.
So now when these people are arguing with me, telling me it wasn't enough, and I go, I read the bill. How many of you have read the bill?
Gone.
This was days ago.
Mic drop.
Guess how many responded to me?
None.
That's correct. None of them have responded to me since. But every single thing I posted on that, this thread of conversation was just, I had 18 different people just coming at me, and I'm like, I'll read it all. Bring me the information that you're getting and I'll read it. And then I'm like, you know what? Here, boom. Here's the bill. What about this do you not like? What about this did you think wasn't enough? Like, we got to start somewhere. This is a great start as far as I'm concerned. This is great.
Yeah.
It's informing more police officers about the history that we have in this country. It's like, all right, so.
Well, you know that Republican conservative voters all over Twitter were mad about this. They said Republicans were basically giving in to the left's demands. But the Democrats reject it.
Yes.
And what, I'm not even going to repeat the word. It's not the worst word in the world, but who was it? Was it Schumer? No, it wasn't Schumer. Who said this?
Nadler. I think it was, yeah. I believe.
Man. No, I don't think it was Nadler.
I'm not sure who said it. I didn't even know that happened. The slur. Yeah,
it was a slur. I'm not going to repeat, and it's not the worst. You know, I probably, like, YouTube would probably allow me to say it. I'm not gonna, because Tim Scott was the one standing up there, and I think he's the only Black Republican.
Okay.
So when he was the one leading the charge on this, they made a comment about his race passively.
Yeah. Okay.
And he got mad about it.
It was Dick Durbin.
I don't blame him.
It was
at
Dick
all.
Durbin.
Yeah, I don't blame him at all.
Scumbag.
And you know, and the more I dig it, the more it is the Democrats that are perpetuating all this. It's like they don't want this to pass, because they're not the ones that proposed it. They're like, well, we can't take the credit for this, so
I need to fact check this.
It's insane.
Maybe you can look this up. But there is a meme image going around. I think it's Booker T. Washington, where he said that there are certain people who have figured out how to essentially, I'm paraphrasing, monetize the grievances of marginalized people. And this
sounds like wow. Sowell, honestly.
Supposedly like Booker T back in the day.
Oh, really?
Yeah, being like, these people know that they can use this for pity and they could. So you fact check me on that one. But yeah, man. Look, it's cliche at this point almost to be like, the Democrats are the real racists.
Right.
But if they're asking for police reform and the Republicans immediately said yes, and it includes a Black History Museum, I'm like, yep. Whoa.
Right.
Wow. And that wasn't enough.
It's like, okay, well,
why do they really want?
I don't get that argument at all, because they could have passed the bill and then said, we should also start working on these other things that you obviously think is not enough. So you obviously think there's more that needs to be done. Okay. Well, what about this bill did you not like? Was not a good start.
It was the R next to the names of those who proposed it.
Exactly. You know,
deadlock, man.
You know, I start looking into it more. It's like the crime bill of 1994, this whole controversy of
was
like
Biden.
Biden was a big part of it. And it's like it was a Democratic thing. And was just like, you know, let me read into this. Let me. And I actually have it pulled up here. I'm just going to read this. This blew me away that this was part of this. The elimination of higher education for inmates. That's part of the bill.
Wow.
You are not allowed to have a higher education now from in jail. Whereas before, you could further yourself, you could finish education and walk out of there as a you know, a better civilian, that you're able to, you know, find a job because you turned being incarcerated into something better. Mm-hmm. It's like, I thought that's what was supposed to be. We're trying to keep people in there.
Rehabilitate.
Yeah, it's like
not retribution.
Yeah, people like to put you on one bracket, either you're in the left or the right. And it's like, no. I am for helping everybody, and this is ridiculous. And the fact that Biden was like standing by it, and now he's, man, I can't believe people aren't freaking out more on this man.
For those that don't know, Adam had a rant about how he, as kind of a moderate default liberal, like you, these are words I'm.
No, that's fine. So they've been calling me a liberal. So.
But you were like just like an urban dwelling New Yorker, hippie vegan gamer skater.
Yeah,
and basically. You had this rant about how you were going to vote for Trump, and Facebook deleted it from like
multiple times, from multiple sources
with millions upon millions of views.
Yep, it's true.
And I have no idea why. I reached out to some of the people like, what happened? No one seems to have an answer.
Yep.
But I look at Project Veritas. They did an expose where these people at Facebook are like, if I see a guy wearing a MAGA hat, I'm deleting it. Mm-hmm. And so sure enough, what happens? You get this dude, Adam, talking about, I started reading into this stuff and listening to Trump, and all of a sudden I'm like, whoa, boom, axed. They can't have you talking about that.
Nope.
But this is why I'm saying, you know, about, you know, civil war, whatever you want to call it. You're one of the most dangerous people to speak up about this.
Maybe.
Because.
Bring it on.
Regular skateboarding, vegan, Brooklynite, you know, whatever dude, all of a sudden being like, whoa, I listened to what Trump had to say and the media was lying about it.
Yep.
And then what? Uh-oh.
I was told today, I'm not allowed to have a voice. I'm not allowed to talk about the issues today because I'm not Black.
It's bro, like, you're gonna get
that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. You can't blame white people on the issues that you claim are happening and not have them be a part of the conversation. That doesn't make any sense to me. Terry Crews. For Terry Crews,
seriously,
you are amazing. He speaks the truth. We have to do this together. We gotta work together. I see the issues that the Democrats, that not only the Democrats, like I don't even want to just keep saying Democrats, because there's a lot of people in charge that are making choices for their own means and not for the general well-being of everybody.
This is the challenge, man. I hate to say it, because I've tried doing the, like, I get it. There are Democrats who are trying to do the right thing, and it's true, but the whole system is rotten. It's just rotten.
I agree. Yep.
I can't tell you, man. Every single, like, what does Nancy Pelosi do? What does Dick Durbin say? They just keep playing the same game.
Yep.
They don't care about actually solving these problems. They make them worse. And it's like they just care for their personal power.
And all those people that you just named, all these people that have been in government for 30, 40, 50 years. It's insane. 50 years?
Yep.
Think about what 50 years ago was.
The civil rights movement?
Exactly. There was one TV that everyone got their information from. They were like, this is what the people need to think. And you can kind of get the vibe that they're like losing their grasp on that. We're all connected because of the internet. Like, look at us right now. We got 45,000 people sitting here with us. Thank you for joining us, but mind you,
holy cow, welcome, it's amazing. Everyone.
And you know what? It's like, because people want to know, they want to have a conversation, they want to figure it out.
That's why we're going to get banned.
Most people are not racist. Most people are in, like, this era of we are.
Listen,
it's your character, it's your heart, it's the weight of the heart that matters the most.
This is why I said in the beginning of the segment, Civil War. The tearing down of Frederick Douglass to me was like, look, when they tore down the Confederates, I went, well, hold on there a minute. You know, it's like, you shouldn't be doing this. Hey, let's have a vote about these things, have a democratic process.
Right.
I don't like the Confederates at all.
Right.
Then they went for Thomas Jefferson, and I was like, whoa, hold on. Then they went for Washington and Grant, and I was like, yo. Then they went for Frederick Douglass, and I wanted to swing a fist. I'm like, yo, dude. Yo.
They have no idea. They have no idea what the things he had to go through to do to become who he became, and to say what he was saying. That was oppression. He fought oppression.
Hans Christian Hegg, I think the name was. He was a Union soldier, colonel, I think, and he died fighting for the Union side, and they desecrated and destroyed his statue and threw it in the river, and I got mad about that.
Yeah.
And that's when I'm like, these people clearly don't care, but I tell you what, man. The mask is off with Frederick Douglass. Hands down,
This
dude was like, he's supposed to embody what they claim to be fighting for. Mm-hmm. They show pictures of Harriet Tubman.
Yep.
Nah, they're lying, man. They want to tear down the people who fought for freedom, liberty, individualism, who upheld the words laid down by the founding fathers and challenge us to hold ourselves to a better standard.
Mm-hmm.
They're trying to destroy it. And when Donald Trump comes out and says there is a leftist cultural revolution that seeks to erase our history, and the media lies and says Trump is heralding Confederates, I'm like, at a certain point, it is not an accident.
Right.
So I can still say a lot of these people are really dumb. But when you have people in media, the question is, when they claim to have watched the video, they're either lying to us, which is malicious.
Yep.
Or they're lying about watching the video, or they're lying about what the video was.
Both are malicious. They're simply malicious now.
They're manipulators.
Absolutely.
The best I can say about what's happening is that we have literal media grifters who are thinking, this will get me clicks.
Mm-hmm.
Like the woman with the gun at the Chipotle, right?
Yep, you're right.
All of the false framing of what really happened with that situation to make us think we got a Karen on our hands.
Right.
It's. I think there are far leftist organizations. I know some of them. I've talked to them. They've explained this stuff to me. They exist. If you want to know their names and find out who these people are, follow Andy Ngo on Twitter, Andy Ngo. He covers this better than I do, and he'll show you their names. He'll explain who they are and what they do. They just found some guy in Portland because they've been rioting for 40 days or whatever now. Mm-hmm. He had pipe bombs.
Yeah, I saw
he had
that.
Explosive materials.
Andy Ngo is the you know the meme where you got the huge, the big jack dog, journalist. And they're like journalists back in the 40s.
Right,
they're like,
they'll
handle anything. And then journalists now, it's like, oh, I've got a boo-boo. And
someone should make
this is
that,
why
right.
transgender rights are real. And it's Andy Ngo, hold on, I just want to finish this. Andy Ngo is a classic, I'm going to go and get the truth, and I don't care what happens to me.
Yeah,
and he's been beat up.
They lie. Like the funniest thing
dude is there was
an incident where he was walking with some right-wing groups.
Okay.
And so they snipped these out of context to prove he was hanging out with them. Why? Because Andy Ngo actually covers who these people are.
Yep.
He drops their names, their police reports, explains what they're doing, what they believe, why they're doing it, and they have to stop him. They brutally beat him in the street because of it, and he's still doing this.
Yep. What a boss.
So you're right. There's that meme of the two dogs. What are they Shibas?
Yeah.
And one super ripped.
Shiba
and,
Chad.
Yeah, there, yes. It's and there's a little scrawny one, and it says journalists in the 30s. I'm gonna get this story. You know, the mafia might kill me, but I'm gonna get this story anyway. Yep. Mm-hmm. It's all ripped, and then today it's like someone called me a mean word on the internet.
I need a month off.
And so you actually have Andy Ngo saying these people brutally beat me in the streets, but I'm not gonna stop.
He does not stop.
And then you have other journalists today who are like someone called me a mean word on the internet, mm-hmm. and that's we have very few people who are actually willing to take the risks to challenge these extremist groups. But that's why I think what he does is important. And not just him, there's other people, but he's probably the highest profile, especially, I think he lives in the Pacific Northwest. But people don't realize it's the insidious nature of what the far left is doing. Mm-hmm. Trying to make sure that their attacks are blunted so they don't generate too much attention. It's almost like you ever play a stealth video game where you have like a stealth meter.
Yeah.
And if they see you too much, the meter grows. And then finally, once it reaches, they see you. Antifa's tactic is that they're lurking around and they have to make sure that meter doesn't fill all the way up and it goes back down. Okay. Mm-hmm. So they'll beat someone up in the street. The meter goes up and they stop, lay low. Then it goes back down. They'll beat up Andy. No, the meter goes, oh no, everyone mm-hmm. sees. Then they wait. Okay. Now we can go again. It's a sustained death. It's a sustained attack, death by a thousand cuts.
Well, the problem is that they have the whole Black Lives Matter movement to hide behind right now.
Yep.
So it's like they don't have to worry about that as much anymore because people are now blaming the Black Lives Matter movement, you know, and I'm not saying that they are not without their own faults. Nobody is, but they have that shield, you know, they're using it. They're like, oh, everyone's just, and people are now blaming the Black Lives Matter. And it's just becoming this big mess of like, well, who's who and who's doing what? And it's right. like,
and people and actual Black Lives Matter activists are quitting. And this is something I bring up a lot. If you watch Dave Chappelle's 8:46 special.
Yeah, I saw it.
He doesn't talk about taxing Amazon. Or Marx or universal healthcare.
Nope.
He talks about people who got killed by cops. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I hear you, man. That's awful. Like, that's a violation of the Fifth Amendment rights, along with a whole bunch of other civil liberties.
Yep.
So I'm down to fight for anybody who was unjustly killed. Where do you get that disconnect? It's because the far left found a way in. Using the brand of Black Lives Matter, they have made themselves invincible. Think about it. How many people lose their jobs when they say, I don't agree with this? Actually, a lot. Then the media, this is what I'm talking about, these media lies. There's a viral tweet going around from this journalist guy saying cancel culture isn't real. Mm. It's basically people, you know, using their voices to hold others accountable for being bigots. There was a viral story of a nurse.
Okay.
She made a Facebook video talking about the looting and the violence, saying, I don't support this and I don't support what these people stand for. She gets fired because of it.
It's ridiculous.
We hear this at schools. We hear about people getting expelled. Cancel culture is very real. The problem is, like I said, it's insidious. It's a blunted attack, a death by a thousand cuts, where they go after people who don't have a strong enough voice to fight back.
Yep.
So all of, you know, when we talk about bias on social media against moderates and conservatives, mostly conservatives, what people, the left tries to play the same game of, look at all these high profile conservatives, you know, people like Ben Shapiro who are doing so well and their voices are so loud. Oh, it's clearly not true. And then what happens is Twitter will ban thousands of regular Trump supporters who will never have a chance to speak up. I've been to events and I can't tell you how many times people have talked to me or sent me messages where they're like, I had 200 followers and I just made some posts, you know, about what, you know, supporting Trump. And then I got banned. I don't know why. And no one knows because they're not high profile.
Yeah.
So they can basically trim all of these, you know, people off of Twitter and force the conversation in a different direction. This keeps happening. And what do we get? I got to be honest. Hey, it's great that the Republicans offered up that reform. But is the best they can do when statues are being torn down is just agree and say, okay, we'll give you what you want. So what do we have? We have Democrats who are seemingly ignoring all the violence, refuse to condemn Antifa on the far left. In fact, Jerry Nadler says they're imaginary. They don't exist. So yeah, every single police report that Andy Ngo has posted is just magic. He just drew a picture. It's not real.
Yeah.
And then the Republicans, very few of them are actually standing up. So I'm not particularly confident. Thanks for checking out this clip from the Timcast IRL podcast. We do the show live Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. If you want to catch the full show, tune into this channel, subscribe, hit the like button, or check us out on iTunes and Spotify. And we will soon have this podcast up for free on all podcast platforms. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you all in the next episode.